M&A activity in the first half of 2017 has been actually very robust. It's a different year than we've seen in prior years. We're now in the fourth year in a row where we're likely going to have volumes over $3 trillion. So it's, by historical measure, it's very healthy. The difference this year is the composition of transactions are really geared towards smaller deals. So whereas in 2015 and part of 2016, we saw more large-scale transactions within certain industries, this year it's really much more $5 billion and below dominating the size of the transaction and what's driving the marketplace. More middle market, upper middle market kind of transaction activity, financial sponsor activity, activity really more geared towards niche acquisitions by corporates. So small deal volumes are up 30%. Large deal volumes, those characterized as over $20 billion in value, are down 40%. So we're really seeing a lack of large-scale consolidating transactions. We think the uncertainty around large transactions is really driven by two major factors. I think the first factor is really the political risk that exists when you look at the lack of progress in Washington. Post the election in the United States, the marketplace, I think, really envisioned more progress being made at this point in the administration around legislative policy. That would have taken the form of tax, infrastructure, something around Obamacare that would have, I think, been perceived as a positive change in the Obamacare legislation. And we've really seen none of that at this point in the year. And it's getting late in the year, and then you wake up and very shortly thereafter, you're kind of into the midterm election process in 2018. So the windows are really narrowing, and I think that's weighing on the marketplace. Like the second large factor is really the broad regulatory environment, which includes antitrust. And I think one of the major impediments right now is the lack of personnel in the seats that matter. So you would expect that this administration would have a more pro-business, traditional Republican orthodoxy bent towards transactional activity and towards large business. But it's very hard to read where they are because they don't have the people in place to really drive the decision-making at this point. But we remain bullish on the balance of the year in 2017 and into 2018 based on the fundamentals that we think remain in place. We do have tremendous capital market support right now, so both the equity and the debt markets are really wide open, very supportive of transaction activity. The markets are really prepared to step in and finance cash-based M&A, which is a tremendous lift for the marketplace, and we expect that to continue.